What's up, Meta Nerds? In today's video, we're going to be talking about the Geonosian Flintknot Speeder, a one-man speeder bike built by the Geonosians and used by the CIS and civilians across the galaxy. The Flintknot was constructed by Hoopla Pacitisk Shipwright Collective, the main shipbuilding corporation on Geonosis, and the same company that would produce the Nantex and Genevex fighters, as well as the Punwarka 116-class interstellar sloop. It was 2 meters, or 6.5 feet in length, which is about two-thirds the length of the common 74Z speeder bike, or about half the length of the Republic's BARC speeder. For a real-world comparison, it was about 2 feet shorter than a Harley-Davidson Ultra Limited. The top speed of 634 kilometers per hour, or 398 miles per hour, was nearly 3 times faster than its ally, the STAP, 134 kilometers faster than the Republic's 74Z, and just barely faster than an LAATI. The Flintknot had a maximum flight altitude of 2 kilometers, or 1.2 miles, which is almost unheard of in speeder bikes, and even higher than some altitudes of certain airspeeders. For example, the T-74 used on Hoth could only get up to 175 meters. This high altitude allowed the Flintknot to easily fly over rough and dangerous terrain. So if this entices you, a new Flintknot would cost you about 8,000 credits, the exact same as a 74Z, while if you knew the right place to look, you could get a used one for 3,000 credits. The design of the Flintknot was radically different from those of other speeder bikes at the time. Most designs, like the common 74Z, had their stabilizers mounted forward, with the driver sitting towards the rear of the vehicle. The Flintknot reversed this, with the stabilizers being far behind the body, and the pilot almost sitting directly up front. This feature is said to have given the Flintknot greater aerodynamics and even better performance. And despite being of Geonosian design, they made sure it could be used by other species, a trait that is not seen in their other designs, like the Nantex. It did, however, come standard with the pheromone scent system, which is integrated into many other Geonosian designs. This unique system would relay diagnostics of the vehicle to the Geonosian pilots through the use of pheromones, instead of just using sounds or visuals like almost every other species in the galaxy. And so that standard model meant to be used for other species did not have this feature, having this easy-to-read diagnostic screen. To recycle parts, Hoopla Pacitisk would actually reuse many parts from their other products as well, with the inertial compensator and artificial gravity generator used to keep the pilot seated being taken off of old Nantex fighters. The standard Flintknot would be unarmed, but there were several modifications that could be applied to this speeder to make it more deadly. A scout version used by the CIS would install a blaster cannon, much like those seen on the 74Z. As for its history, it's unknown when the Flintknot production began, but we do know its role. Started off as a scout speeder used by the Geonosians to track down and hunt the native Aklays, Murdeths, or even the larger creatures that roam Geonosis. Other than for hunting, the Geonosians would also use the speeders for perimeter patrols around their hives, or for examining the impact sites of meteors. Because remember, Geonosis has those enormous planetary rings. A Flintknot would be given to Count Dooku right before the outbreak of the Battle of Geonosis. In this first battle of what would become the Clone Wars, Dooku would use his Flintknot to escape the Petronaki Arena. While heading towards the secret hangar where his private solar sail was stationed, Dooku and his escort of 2 Nantex would come under fire from an LAATI with Obi-Wan and Anakin aboard.
It's Dooku! Shoot him down!
We're out of rockets, sir.
Follow him!
We're gonna need some help!
There isn't time!
The gunship would give chase to the speeder, but thanks to the Flintknot's faster speed, he was able to evade the Republic gunship. After he left Geonosis, he would abandon his Flintknot inside of the hangar, but he later either came back to reacquire it, or just got a new one later on in the war, as a Flintknot was used during his mission to intercept Anakin Skywalker on Tatooine. But this would be stolen by Anakin and used instead to save his new Padawan, Ahsoka Tano. Sadly, that would be the last Flintknot we see and used by Count Dooku. After the start of the Clone Wars, this speeder would enter into the CIS as a more conventional alternative to the STAP. CIS's Flintknots would be painted in the blue and gray color scheme, and were now modified to be used by droids. And we see that most of the Flintknots used in CIS service would be used by more advanced units, being preferred by commando and tactical droids over the standard B1s. Interestingly, and a very funny visual, is that some were modified to be used by B2 super battle droids, their enormous frames all crunched up onto that little seat. And so maybe these B2s are modified to be lighter and have additional sensors for a scouting role, and or they just boosted some of the power of the repulsors. And we see that it would go on to be used on many worlds for many different conflicts. On Naboo, the tactical droid TR-350 would be piloting a Flintknot when he was captured by security forces. During the Battle of Kairos, the speeder would be used by a squad of commando droids to face off against Republic BARC speeders. The BARC had a tactical advantage in this battle, as their mounted blasters made short work of the unarmed Flintknots. If any of the commando droids wanted to fight back, they had to either get into close range to melee the clones on their speeders, or multitask by firing their E5s while still trying to drive at the same time. Several Flintknots would be present at the CIS security outpost on the planet Anaxes. Those would be captured by Clone Force 99 and Captain Rex to use as an escape from this facility. The Gungan minister and Separatist collaborator Rishi Lu would also use this speeder to escape Oda Gunga after his true allegiance was discovered by Anakin and Padme. Despite being mainly in CIS use, the Geonosians would still operate with a Flintknot speeder on their homeworld, and they would see frontline action again during the Second Battle of Geonosis, while several of these bugs on Flintknots would assault the Republic ground forces that had just landed there. And really interesting is that we wouldn't only see them in CIS use. A handful of Flintknots were captured by the Republic and actually sent back to Coruscant, where the clones or other personnel who had captured the speeders would use them as personal transport around the city. Several of these would be parked outside of a nightclub, and one would be used by Clone Trooper Fives to escape Republic authorities when he was framed for the attempted assassination of Supreme Chancellor Palpatine. After the Clone Wars, we don't hear much from the Flintknot. Production probably halted, and the design may have been lost to history after the genocide of the Geonosian people. So that's it for its breakdown in history. The only cool behind-the-scenes facts is that it was created for Attack of the Clones, but you get those funny B-2 riding ones in Star Wars Galactic Battlegrounds. And additional information comes from the Star Wars Encyclopedia of Starfighters and Other Vehicles, the Visual Encyclopedia, and that Legends cross-section comes from Star Wars Complete Cross-Sections. If you want to connect with us on social media, find ways that you can support the channel for free, or check out our Patreon and PayPal, be sure to check out the links in the description. Special shout-out to our supporters over on Patreon. But most important of all, remember, you might look lame, but not big scary Sith on a flying scooter lame. And the Force will be with you. Always.